Hi, howdy. It's Wednesday, I think. I haven't been training. So, on Monday last week, so more than a week ago, Kevin and I went and got our booster shots for COVID. So we'd gotten to Pfizer before, and then long, uninteresting story. I'd purchased Moderna before I was able to get my Pfizer shots because they called my age group pretty late. So I'd purchased them as kind of like a safety net. And so we were like, oh, we can use them as boosters. Unfortunately, because Moderna is one of these vaccines that has to be kept like super, super cold, it expires. So the hospital called me and they're like, hey, all the shots you already paid for are going to expire. So you need to use them before March 17th, which is pretty early for me. Like, my second shot of Pfizer was in November, so this is like pretty fast for me to be getting a booster, but it's gonna expire, so I'm like, hey, go do it. Kevin and I both went on Monday. I had really, really rough side effects on Monday and for like half of Tuesday. Kevin was a little bit slow after me, but he's held up pretty well. So on Monday night, like the same day that we'd gotten our booster shots in the morning, Carhat came in the evening because he had to get his second injection of PRP. We're helping him with PRP treatment for his knee. He's had a problem with his knee for like 3 years. You can go and see a post about that where through the generosity of my patrons and being able to take care of legends and literally preserving the legacy in this case and being able to keep Carhat moving the way that he moves, because who Carhat is really how he moves, still being able to teach and that kind of thing. So he came Monday night and I was like, hey buddy, sorry, Kevin and I are totally gonna be just like laying in the room for a quick minute because we got vaccinated today and we feel like ass. So he was like, okay, no problem. So he stayed, and I started feeling better the next day, and then I took him to his appointment for his injection. Everything was fine. After his injection, I went back to just training myself in the afternoon so I could kind of like gear myself up to be able to go spar with Yodkunpan in the morning. Did that. Everything was going good. Spar with Yodkunpan was like kind of tired and like lacking explosiveness, but like most of my symptoms from the vaccine were gone, and not really feeling anything other than tired. So worked with him Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And then Saturday afternoon, I wasn't feeling very well. And so I decided to just take the afternoon off. I was like, all right, I just clearly haven't like rested fully after taking my vaccination, and I'm just gonna chill out. So I took Saturday off. Sunday, I wasn't feeling very good. I felt kind of like I had a cold, like I've had this like stuffed nose. I was coughing a little bit, but just, you know, feels like a cold kind of thing. Sunday, rest day, normal rest day, I decided to take a COVID test just to, you know, because it's been going around. I know tons of people who have been getting it. It's like really, really getting through everyone now. Took a COVID test and it came back positive. I was like, like, how did I get COVID having just gotten my booster shot? I know there are breakthrough infections. I know how science works. I know how all of this is, but I was mad about it. I was like, how did this happen? So I had to let everyone know, have everyone test themselves, blah, 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 all this stuff. Absolutely nobody who I've been in contact with has come back positive. Kevin hasn't tested himself because we live together, obviously. Anything I have, he's going to have. There's no use in testing it, but he has no symptoms. He doesn't go anywhere, like any of this stuff. So basically from Sunday, when I got my positive result on my ATK test at home, and now it's Wednesday, it's basically been like a week since things started getting like a little bit shifty. I feel much, much better. I still have a little bit of a stuffy nose, but other than that, like not a whole lot. It really just feels like a cold. But I have this very weird like moral guilt about having caught COVID, which is crazy because I actually know, like, tons of people I know have gotten COVID and I never felt this way about them. I was never like, you did the wrong thing. And I've done all of the responsible things. I've been vaccinated. I stay home. I wear my mask. I, you know, wash my hands. I do all of these things. The minute I tested positive, I contacted everyone I've been in contact with. They all tested themselves. They're all fine. So, you know, that's good. But there's this weird, like, kind of, like I did something wrong by catching it or something. And Kevin was pointing out, he's like, this is about to become endemic. Like, Thailand is actually looking to make COVID endemic by July 1st. It's like really, really soon. Which, what that means, if people aren't familiar with this word, pandemic means that it's like going around, it's around the world. Endemic means that it's in the population all the time and it's never going away. So like the flu is endemic, chicken pox is endemic, the cold is endemic. Hey, bud. This is the first time Bun has jumped up onto this bench with me in the mornings. Usually I have to like force him up here. He's spazzing out because he's not getting attention at every second. It's very, very hard for him. So with Thailand about to declare COVID endemic, that means that people won't have to like test before coming to the country. You probably still have to test once you arrive just to kind of like keep things in check. But it's basically like live with the disease kind of thing. That Kevin's like, if it took you 2 years of this pandemic to actually get COVID, that's pretty impressive, which I think is actually kind of true. And I'm very lucky. My symptoms have been incredibly mild. It honestly is just like a cold. I haven't had any kind of like respiratory thing. I had a little bit of a cough, but it was not like there's no chest pain. There's no difficulty breathing. I'm not training, so I don't know whether my like ability to exert myself is zero or what that'll be when I finally get back to training. When I was still training with Yodkun Pan, I was noting how badly I was doing just because I had no explosiveness, which was actually really instructive. This was really interesting to me because the way that like sparring or dominance or whatever works, I've noted, is kind of like getting a car rolling. So like once you get the car rolling, it'll go, but it's very hard at the onset to like get the car moving from nothing to something. But then once it's rolling, you can kind of push it in that direction. That's what dominating someone is like. You have to get the car rolling in a direction. And once you get it rolling, which is you kind of like throw two or three things at someone, you clip them with one and that kind of interrupts their roof or interrupts their rhythm. And then you can kind of keep going. That's getting the car rolling. So basically Yodkun Pan had his car rolling on me the entire time. And I lacked explosiveness to be able to kind of like jerk out of that direction and change direction or like get on a different beat or anything like that, which was really interesting to me. That is like, explosiveness is really important in that sense, rather than the like, oh, your kicks have to be explosive so no one sees them. Like, yes, that's true also, but the explosiveness of being able to like redirect the way things are going for dominance to me was really interesting. I lacked that, maybe because I was sick. I don't know when I got sick or where I got sick. So thankfully I haven't spread it to anybody, but I don't know where it came from. But definitely, I don't know whether it was from the side effects of the vaccine or whether it was because I was sick already that I was lacking that explosiveness, but that might not be there when I'm well again and back to training. So I have to kind of prepare for that and figure out how I'm going to be working that back in or working with a complete lack of that. That should be interesting. But yeah, this is basically just my vlog about how I've been home, spending way too much time on my phone, watching a lot of good movies with Kevin. That's been actually really nice. Getting to spend time with Kevin, just being home and relaxing. Like, we have a rest day every week on Sundays, but I kind of get agitated on Sundays because I feel like there's tons of stuff I need to do that I haven't had time to do during the week because I'm training. So errands kind of stuff, like, that's not actually fun to do. And Kevin is always like, your rest days are not super restful, because I'm like running errands on them. But I can't go anywhere. Like, I'm like stuck here. We've been using like delivery services because I can't even go to the store kind of thing, which is a little bit of a game changer because I didn't know how those worked. I've never been forced to use them before, but that actually kind of frees me up a little bit to be able to have someone go to the store for me just to get like very small essentials rather than making a big trip across town, because Kevin and I live like outside of Pattaya City now, so everything's a little bit farther away. It's been nice to be home. We watch a bunch of movies together. They've all been pretty good, and the ones that are bad we don't like together, so that's nice. And I am so eager. I'm so eager to get back to training. I don't know when that'll be. I'm hoping that'll be at the start of next week. I have to pass 2 ATK tests, get negative results on 2 ATK tests to be able to feel confident that I'm not contagious, no longer carrying the virus, and I can go back to being around other people. So I'm a little bit obsessive as a person, and so I'm trying to like remind myself that testing myself every day while I still have symptoms means absolutely nothing. It's just a waste of tests. Like, clearly I need to wait until all my symptoms are gone, and then maybe the next day test myself to see whether the virus has cleared from my body or not. I don't need to be testing myself while I'm still, you know, with a clogged nose and this kind of thing. So dealing with a lot of things about myself I don't necessarily have to face when I'm busy training all the time, but hoping that I get back to training really soon. Thank you guys for watching my blah blah. Not a super exciting update because I'm not really doing a whole lot other than laying around, but this is how it is. This is how it goes. Cheering other people on TV who have fights and that kind of stuff.